Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. And tonight we're gonna have today we are going to have to discuss something also that is very controversial. Although I do not discuss celebrity news on this channel, I usually leave that up to my hi. Hi. I usually discuss celebrity news on my Spotify. Can I call it that? I do this usually on podcasts where my podcast channel where I discuss celebrity news, but this is a very special occasion because I feel like this is a very relevant to some of the driving force of how we view political issues and the agenda of media as it pertains to what our di what our attention is directed towards. Because the recent scandal that is being revolved, re not resolved, or that is evolving in the media is about a few artists, too numerous to mention at this point, involved in some very sketchy kind of behavior. Behavior that, if you were like me, into pop culture enough to watch how certain things have evolved in the narrative that is being shared, you would understand that this is not news because this is something that we've been discussing in Black media. As a matter of fact, I made a video very recently about that, going into grave detail as to the narrative that's being pushed and why. Now, all of a sudden, we are starting to discuss various angles of various types of individual behavior when I clearly remember being it being known openly about how certain people in Hollywood act and what is allowed to be done and not done about it. So, why this is now coming up into the forefront of media is the greater question that needs to be asked as it pertains to people's alleged involvement in said unspoken activities. And how this these activities affect their now principle and position as it starts to unravel before our very eyes. But enough about my perspective. Let's get into some of the comments that are being shared online, and I want to hear from you guys the general ideologies that you think is being questioned and why.
Bickering in our division. It was
Who?
Like follow the money. Now, I don't know their names, Bill, but if you follow the money, you go high enough, you start to see, okay, you know, this is an industry. Okay, let's take rap music.
Let's take okay. it.
Same people who own the labels own the prisons. So
to really think clearly about how narratives are built, how they're maintained, and for what reason. Because there have been several people, especially in the past decade, who have been actively bringing to our attention how deceiving and deceptive a lot of media houses are as it pertains to the narrative that's being pushed. Now, I will leave it up to you to come to your own conclusions as to why narratives are pushed or why certain narratives are held back. Because I believe that it is your free, God-given right to think about everything that you've been taught and why you were taught that, and begin to really unravel for yourself and unpack the narrative if you feel like it is necessary to understand why certain narratives are being pushed, or your own understanding of where you stand on certain issues and why. Is this even important for you? And if it is important or not, why is it important? Because narratives that are being fed that we cling to and believe help to shape and mold what we think about ourselves, what we think about society, and how we go about conducting ourselves in society. My generation was the first, in my opinion, to use media as a social reference point of how people behave in society. And of course, we are seeing many people come forward and start to talk about how deliberate it was for those things to be, for that to happen, so that we no longer draw our narrative and our social understanding from families, but from television, movies, you know, people in the media and people in videos and artists and rappers and people that we basically have seen.
Never catch a list, roll up with no beards, cause bitches ain't shit. That's all my crew was dead, a bunch of knuckleheads.
That a pimp named Slickback can co-sign Rowdy. I mean, don't get me wrong, a pimp named Slickback will put a lot of things over a hoe. Money over a hoe? Always. Brand new gators over a hoe? Absolutely. A turkey sandwich with just tomato? Guaranteed. But homies? Oh no. A pimp named Slickback don't do sh** for the homies. Let me reiterate, don't do sh** for the homies. Unless the homie wanna walk that stroll and get that money, the homie ain't getting a damn thing. And the same goes for brothers, peeps, dudes, fellas, dunnies, comrades.
Truth and nothing but the truth, so help me God. Now, I've had to turn down $50 million 4 times. 4 times. Just to protect my integrity and that virgin hole I was telling you about. Right. Because P. Diddy be wanting to party. And you gotta tell him no. You got to tell him no. I did. See, I got the receipt for everything I'm telling you. That's why I can say them so freely. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Like this, Daddy.
Yeah, will you put my bed
Daddy, in? I like when you scrambling and scraping for shit.
No,
I like that.
You know, I've been practicing. I got yeah. Mr. Lee,
yeah, I love this drink.
Will you put my bed?
I like when you like this, Daddy.
Yeah, will you put my bed?
Daddy, I like when you scrambling and scraping when you.
Nasa papaya.
What's up? You can live here, you can record here, you can be bad boy artists here, but if you want to do it, first y'all got to walk to Queens and give me a sugar cookie. Sugar cookie, man, this is crazy. Yeah, come on, man. Bad boy. Hey, sugar cookie, man. Look, this is not what I got in the music business to be doing. Be a sugar cookie getter, you know, I'm a rapper. Who are the 5 best rappers of all time? Think about it.
On television and not anyone in our communities. This is very, very, very intentionally done. And on the surface, seems quite harmless. But now, we are starting to understand that that's not the case. And I really, really would want us to start to pay attention now that why is it that this opportune moment that we're starting to just now discuss the people that brought us the narratives that they bought and hold them accountable for the damages that they have done to the communities for generations now at this point. Because I'm now in my 40s, I have children, and I know some of your children have children. And so we're talking now 3 generations that has been shaped and molded by a particular set of stories and role models that don't seem to be having our best interests at heart. I want to make sure that you guys understand that this is no harm, no foul. I mean, I'm not even going to call out names. I'm just going to be sharing some videos in this video, in this, you know, this piece, but I will not be speaking particularly about any particular person because I think it's a long time coming. But for the most part, where I stand is that it's kind of a distraction. A distraction from what? Well, we will wait to see.